we are going to do the three types of damping. The first case that we are taking is the overdamped or the heavily damped oscillations. Because oscillations now are heavily damped, so damping factor must be greater than the stiffness term. So this is damping term and this is stiffness term. So R square by 4m square, it must be greater than S by m. If this is the case, then because B square is greater than omega naught square, so this term would be positive value. So if it is positive, then we could write here like cosh of root B square minus omega naught square t plus sine hyperbolic under root of B square minus omega naught square t. Similarly, we can write for the negative value also a2 cosh of root b square minus omega naught square t minus sine hyperbolic root b square minus omega naught square t. So this is the value that we have obtained here. So next what we will do is to combine the cosh terms from here also and from there. So these two terms we are combining, and also sine terms we are combining. So we have two new constants, like a1 plus a2 is another constant, and the second constant is a1 minus a2. So these are the constants that we have taken. So now x is a non-periodic function now. So because we have taken here hyperbolic functions, those are non-periodic. So from here we can see that x function, that is displacement, it would decay exponentially to zero. So this is the case, is discussed, that heavily damped case in which the x is decreasing exponentially, and the motion here we can see that the motion is non-oscillatory. So this variation is shown here. In the next case, when we are taking critically damped oscillations, in critical damped oscillation, B square value, we have taken it to be equal to omega naught square. So both of these values are same. So it means the value root B square minus omega naught square would be equal to zero. So here we can see that A1 e raised to power zero plus A2 e raised to power minus zero. So this will give you A1 plus A2 e raised to power minus BT. So this will give us G, another constant, e raised to power minus BT. So this shows that the displacement is decaying to zero exponentially. Okay. So but the only thing is, because we have because we have only one constant, there should be two constants, because it was a second degree differential equation. So for the second degree differential equation, the constants must be two. So what we have taken is, we have taken that b square is slightly more than omega naught square. So if it is slightly more than omega naught square, so it means we have taken this value to be delta. So plus delta k minus delta, plus delta t minus delta t we have taken here. And then after from that, we can have the two constants here. So this is another case where the critically damped is shown like here. Also it decays exponentially, but it decays with the, and it will recover to it will cover a whole length. The more time it will take to decrease to zero, so here the time taken for the system to return to its initial state, it will depend upon the value of B. Okay, so B would in turn depend upon R. So the behavior is said to be deadbeat. Okay. So next we are taking lightly damped oscillations in which the damping is very small. So it means B square is having lower value than omega naught square. So R square by 4m square is less than S upon m. So when we are filling this value in our solution, because here the stiffness term is dominating, so B square minus omega naught square is negative, omega square naught square is negative. Here it should be negative, not sign. So therefore we can write like this. So we are now taking negative of this over all this. So minus 1, when we are taking the under root of minus 1, it will give you iota root of omega naught square minus b square. So we are, again, what we are doing, that omega naught square minus b square, we are filling it to be omega naught dash. Okay. So just let me write here, omega naught square minus b square is equal to omega naught dash. We are taking this like this, omega naught square dash the whole square. So that its value is iota omega naught. So we have here iota omega naught t, and in the second term we have minus iota omega naught t. So this is the value that we have got here. So from e raised to power iota theta, as you know, we can write it as cos theta plus iota sine theta. So we are simply writing the terms here. From this term e raised to power iota theta, we can write here e raised to cos of theta plus iota sine of theta. So cos omega naught dash t plus iota sine omega naught dash t, plus this the same procedure for the second term also. So here again we are combining the cos terms and sine terms, so we are getting here a new kind of variables. So now we have taken a1 plus a2 to be a naught cos phi, and iota a1 minus a2 to be I naught sine phi. So we can write here a cos omega naught t, and this as this was cos omega naught t, and the cos theta is written here. Okay, so let me clear this. A1 plus A2 has been replaced by a naught cos phi multiplied by cos omega naught t cos omega 2 is here. Okay. So similarly, in case of this, we have put a naught sine theta, a naught sine theta, sine phi we have put. So sine omega dash t is there. So this will give you cos a cos b plus sine a sine b with the same constant. So which will reduce further to cos of a minus b. So cos of omega dash t minus phi. So this is what we have got as our solution. Okay. So furthermore, what we have put is the different values of a naught and phi and omega naught dash. This we have put, and complete solution is given here. So what we have done is we have calculated the value of a naught. A naught is just take these two equations, a1 plus a2 is equal to a naught cos phi, and iota a1 minus a2 is equal to a naught sine phi. So when we will square and add both these equations, so we are getting here a naught square cos square phi plus a naught square sine square phi is equal to this whole square plus this whole square. This whole square plus this whole square with under root sign. Okay. So this will be the value of a naught. So from this we are calculating it, and we have shown that a naught is equal to 2 under root of a1 multiplied by a2. Also, when we will divide these both equations, we will get sine phi upon cos phi, we will get it to be tan phi would be equal to this value divided by this value. So iota a1 minus a2 divided by a1 plus a2. So this is something which we have got. And also, as I have written earlier, also omega naught square minus b square is equal to omega naught dash square. So this is what they have written here. And this is the, after filling all the values, like we have filled b to be r by 2m, and omega naught dash to be s by m minus r square by 4m whole square into, like this we have taken, and t minus phi. So this is the final equation that we have come across. Here you can see that this is the equation of simple harmonic motion which is having the frequency omega naught dash. Okay, so this is omega naught dash, and it has amplitude this a naught e raised to power minus bt or minus r by 2mt. So as you know, that amplitude is decreasing. Yes, it is decreasing with time. This amplitude is decreasing with time. The amplitude is decreasing exponentially with time. but it is not decreasing to that extent as we compare with the earlier cases. The oscillations, they would cease almost during the same time in which the critically damped oscillator returns to its initial stage. So we can see from the graph also that we can see this. For the lightly damped oscillations, the oscillations would decrease like this. The oscillation would be like this. And also the amplitude is decreasing. As you see that amplitude is not remaining the constant. If it would have remained constant, it would be like this. So the amplitude is decreasing, but it is decreasing slowly. And also also the line is matching with the critically damped oscillations. So you can see here clearly that this is the basic difference between the lightly damped oscillations and the critically damped oscillations, and the third case that we have done is heavily damped oscillations.